In a bid to end child marriages, the vice president cautioned men to respect young children, asked girls to respect themselves and their parents in order to fulfill their parenthood responsibilities.
We also call upon all the girls to respect themselves, restrain themselves, and also exercise maximum discipline so that they are safe and secure until they finish all the education cycles. I also call upon all the parents to give that child honor. Let the girl child go to school. Just ask the boy child if going to school. And also the child with disability.
She's also implored residents to embrace PDM and adopt commercial farming from subsistence farming as a way to alleviate themselves from poverty.
I'm also here to remind us that it's our roles and responsibilities to participate in government programs that can help our regions to leap from where we are.
The first Deputy Prime Minister, Right Honourable Alitwala Rebecca Kadaga, asked the government to set up vocational schools for teenage mothers.
The theme for the Women's Day internationally is digitization. But I'm worried that if our children continue falling out of school, they will not have an opportunity to study science, they will not be able to access technology, and then they will fall out of the bracket of the economy. Therefore, it's very important that we speak to them, sensitize them, and mobilize the entire community.
Grappling with the aftermath of COVID, where we had so many of our girl children drop out of school and also conceiving at an early age that cannot be retained in the workforce, in the labor market, because they're not professional in anything. Neither are they of age of consent that they can establish or found a family. Therefore, for you people in government, just like we are, but you are at the policy formulation level, we need a serious affirmative action to see how best we can help these young mothers that they can have life meaning if they continue and that the productivity in their families is helped.
According to leaders, Kamuli and Mayuge districts are leading in teenage pregnancy and early marriage in Busoga region. There is a need for action from the government and area leaders. Records from the United Nations Population Fund as of 2021 rated Mayuge and Kamuli as some of the districts having highest teenage pregnancy cases in the country. Kamuli registered 6,535, whereas Mayuge registered 6,205 teenage pregnancies. Report by Nathan Sengoba for the news.